Right, morning guys. It's the 2nd of March today. Another lovely day. We had some rain overnight. Well, I think we did. We'll have a look in here. Not much. Half a mil, if that. That's disappointing. Because I know there is a lot of people around that got a lot more rain than us. Including Sam from the olive farm, who told me that he had 23 mils in under an hour. We've not even had a half a mil, so for whatever reason we seem to be missing out at the moment. All right, we made it out north this morning, and it is quite a bit wetter out here than it is at home, so we're just going to measure the rain. How much is that?
7 mil.
7 mil. Oh well, it's a fair bit more than we had back at home. Should make the loosen grow a bit, which would be nice. Right, so I just filled up the drench container and brought that over. What the drench is it's a worm medicine. So the sheep pick up tapeworms, or whatever you call them, paddock worms. Not earthworms, a different type of thing. These worms live in the gut of the sheep, and as the sheep eat food, the food gets into the gut of the sheep, but before the sheep can take use of the nutrients, the worms that eat it. So the sheep can be eating a lot of feed but not actually gaining any weight. So that's why we do it now, or that's why we do it. And what we're using is Cydectin oral drench. This is all in the best interest of having as healthy sheep as we possibly can. All right, we got the compressor going. Check the oil in it. There was not much oil, but we put some in there. We've got the vaccine. This is just a vaccine that all of our breeding ewes get every year. It's just stops them getting some common diseases. It's called Glenvac 6, or 6-in-1, because it stops them, vaccinates them against 6 different diseases, which is always a good thing. All right, so we had a little bit of trouble with not having any power to the crate, but that was because the connectors on the battery were not connected properly. Anyway, now we're running the first ones in. Yep, you go. Come on. Oh, why has it done that? Okay, first one in. This sheep here has got 2 ear tags, and what that tells me is that this one's a pet. And I remember green and orange was Coco. A few years ago, Chelsea and I bottle fed this one, and its name's Coco. It's not friendly anymore, but hey Coco. Here we go, there's the last one. 376. Alright, so we got our sheep in from way down the back. This is not all of them. We split off half, or maybe more than half, and put them in the stock containment yards down there. We'll attack them in the morning. But we got these ones into the yards. We're just about to pen them all up, and then we'll start drenching and vaccinating these ones. In you go. Alright, so we're just working away here. You can see I give them vaccine and then a needle, and then a drench, and let them out. It's squeezes the next one. I don't like it too much, but it's good for me. Well, my dog's slacking off a bit back there. Up you go. There you go. Now you see, you've got the draft set up. That's for nothing more than interest sake. I just want to know what weight range our ewes are and how many of each weight range we have. So the lighter ones are going out that side, the average ones are going forwards, and then the heavy ones are going that way. Now, saying that, the light ones, this one's classed as a light one, it's still a heavy sheep. They're in good nick, I tell you. Done this half. The other half are still in the stockyards, but we'll do them tomorrow. We did 177 and the average weight was 83 kilos. That was in good nick. They're doing well, that's for sure. Alright, so the sheep that were in the stockyards last night, we brought them up. We've just finished drenching and vaccinating them. And there happens to be 269 of them at an average of 81.5 kilograms. They're definitely in good nick and they were full of fight. That's for sure. My poor old tractor driver hands couldn't cope with it. I got some blisters and anyway, we made it through. Right, what up, farm? We're out here, we've already started for today. We are drenching and needling our merino ewes back at home, and have a look at that wool. They got a bit on them and it's looking pretty nice. Tomorrow the crutching contractor is coming and they're all getting crutched. So as I was saying, the crutching contractor's coming tomorrow, they'll all get crutched, and yeah. This is just in preparation for that, so we'll get into it. All right, so our Glenvac 6 has run out here. We've got the new one. I'm gonna give it a shake up. Shake, 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 shake. Put our string on. nuts. That's the classic granny knot here. Oh, look at that. There we go. We're gonna get our old one. Take the old bottle off. You'll see in there, there's a spike and a rubber here. So the spike goes through the rubber and then the collar screws on. It's not leaking, should be right to go. Ready to vaccinate some more youth. Going along, nearly got this lot done. Alex is coming for a look. Can you wave? Good job. We're getting through them. We got them all done, Alex. Now we've just got to go and shut the gate so that they stay in their paddock. Do you want to come for a walk? Alright, so we finished that mob. Now we're going to go and get the next mob of sheep in. Alex has demanded that she wear her seatbelt and I wear mine, which is good. It's a good habit to be in. Safety first.